time to bring the bass back. Mix is the beat of our culture. Our stories.
So I see myself having a couple number ones, number one albums.
Spotlighting inspiring content from Generation Mix. The next generation of creators, artists, and filmmakers. Our music. Discover fresh artists first from around the world. Uniquely Filipino.
It's hard to get this energy anywhere else.
Mix is the beat of our culture.
All right, Phyllis, how you guys doing, man?
Good, so good. Yeah, just pretty busy.
For everyone that's tuning in right now, obviously you know who I'm with. I'm with James Reed and, of course, King Waf, Careless. Thank you guys so much for your time. And first thing I want to say is I'm loving Biggie behind you guys. That's dope.
Yeah, yeah. All day.
Did someone paint that for you, or where'd you get that?
Yeah, we had an artist come in and paint it. Actually, right now we're at Brooklyn Social. It's a barbershop.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Dope. So, Biggie. Is Biggie your favorite rapper? I remember Brett was saying that he's one of his top, right? That's your favorite.
Yes.
All right. I know, James, you're not really a rapper, but do you have a favorite rapper?
Yeah, I like Biggie. I think we did this before on the show. You asked us, is it Biggie or Tupac?
That's right. That's right. That was like years ago. That's right. I remember now. All right, but I'm a Tupac guy, so that's the only problem I have with you guys. Everything else is cool.
Hey, that's why you're there and we're here.
All right, man. So let's get this thing started. Like, you know, what have you learned about yourselves during this pandemic, man? Because, you know, a lot of people are saying they have time to reflect now more than ever. And I know you guys are keeping yourselves busy, obviously, with all these projects coming out and stuff. But is there anything that you haven't answered yet in other interviews where you realize that you've come to some realization about yourself? Anything like that over the last 6 months?
I remember, like, one of the first interviews I had, I said, like, it's been, like, really meditative being able to just take a pause from, you know, this automatic, you know, routine that we get ourselves into, and then just think about, you know, what is really important. Because, you know, when you're in, like, a state of emergency, you know, it really forces you to focus on what is really important and, you know, the best way to move forward. And, you know, just really, you know, wakes you up and, you know, forces you to get your act together.
For sure. Definitely. And I just talked to Brett a couple of weeks ago. So it's good to see you again, man. In the last few weeks since I talked to you, man, you know, we were talking about Nadine's Wildest Dreams video coming out at that point. It came out on the 31st. What have the last 2 weeks been like for you guys?
It's been pretty hectic since the launch. The launch itself was, you know, quite a feat for us. You know, we had it streaming across like so many different platforms. It was on our YouTube, Facebook, it was on Twitter, it was on TikTok, it was on Kumu, it was also on ABS-CBN. So yeah, that was a really hectic night, but you know, thanks to, you know, our marketing team, they were able to pull off, you know, that huge event. And you know, since then the reception's been great, and you know, people's minds seem to have been blown by the visual album, which is what, you know, I think that's the reaction we were really going for.
Yeah. Brett was really hyping it up, because I was talking to him a couple of weeks ago, man. He was like really making me excited. So when I finally saw it, I was very, very happy about it. And correct me if I'm wrong, is this the first full visual album in OPM history?
That's what we've been told. We didn't, when we were making it, we didn't realize that, you know, it was the first visual album, you know, in Filipino history. So, yeah.
Hey, that's dope.
Yeah, that's pretty dope.
That's dope. And I know at the end there was some type of like alternate ending. Did you have a couple more of those up your sleeve that you haven't showed anyone yet? Are there a couple more?
There is.
Okay.
There's one alternate ending. I'm not sure if it was shown completely.
Okay.
But we will be revealing that. There are a lot of reasons why we wanted to keep that one, and then a lot of reasons not to. But you know, either way, we still want people to see it.
Okay, cool. So our good friends, Transparent Arts and the Far East Movement team, just announced that you're part of their team. you could have chosen to work with any group in the state. So what appealed to you about them the most? And what does it mean? Is there more in store for you, like, internationally, obviously? Or, you know, what's going on with that?
Right before quarantine happened, I was able to spend some time over in LA with Verman. He's, you know, he's in Far East Movement. And he's also one of the co-founders of TA. And I think for me, it was really just the people. It was Verman. It was, you know, James Pro. They're really good guys. And basically, you know, they see potential in the Philippines, and, you know, they recognize what we're trying to achieve with Careless. And they're not just supporting me. They're also supporting, you know, all the artists in Careless. And
nice.
Yeah, it's just, it was great to meet them all. And, you know, they really want to help us really kind of expand into, you know, other markets and, you know, help with getting, you know, the resources that we lack here that, you know, there's so much of in LA.
Right, right.
Yeah, there's you know, a lot of exciting stuff happening, especially 2021.
Can't wait for it, man. Can you believe it's already almost the end of the year?
That's crazy. No, just like that.
It's crazy. So for this question is for Brett. Brett, you know, I know you've been working hands-on with a lot of stuff that goes on in Careless, but when you look at this year, 2020 is like a blur. You know, it was a pandemic. First half of it, we're locked in the house. And then the second half, it seems like all the creatives really doubled down on their hard work. So when you look back on this year, you know, and maybe when you get older, when you have kids or grandkids, what are you going to tell them about 2020, man?
I think 2020 was a cultural reset for a lot of people. It was just like, okay, a lot of the businesses had to scramble to see what they were going to do. So it kind of leveled out the playing field for everyone, which gave opportunities for companies like Careless to take a step forward, even in a time where everyone was kind of taking a few steps backwards.
Right.
So in light of all the tragedy and things that were happening, it's been a great time to try to do something new and innovative.
For sure, for sure. And, you know, do you guys prank with each other a lot? Because, you know, I'm going to bring this up, James. I know you probably have been warned that, you know, that Billy Crawford prank was pretty funny, bro. That was hilarious.
No, that wasn't funny at all, bro.
Well, in hindsight, of course, at the time, you were probably like, what the hell is going on?
Yeah, yeah. I didn't even know I was on TV. Like, I thought it was just a prank. So I was like cussing and stuff and had to bleep it. How much I had in my bank account. Oh, my God. I told Billy, like, yo, I'm going to kill you.
Oh, man, it was hilarious. Was that, like, the biggest prank ever pulled on you, do you think?
Definitely in, like, in recent history. Like, I mean, it wasn't just a prank. It was a televised prank. So, yeah.
All right.
I got people hitting me up on in my DMs and on my Twitter and, like, Instagram, all asking for money. And I don't know if they're kidding or not. But, yeah, it's...
I think it might take about a year for you to let anyone borrow money. I think you're going to think everyone's pulling a prank.
I trust issues now, bro.
like, who's a clown of Careless? Like, who's, like, the one that would pull pranks or, like, the funniest one in the group?
Jericho? Yeah, probably Jericho. But if you're talking about the artists, probably say Messiah.
Yeah.
Messiah.
Yeah, he's a real joker.
He seems like he's a joker. And he's always happy, man. And every time I see him or talk to him, he's always smiling. Like, his vibe is just always like, hey, what's going on? Hey, like that. All right. Well, your fans have also been dying for you to release I Know You. Is it? Can you?
I Know You Care.
I Know You Care.
I Know You Care. There you go. Sorry. I Know You Care. You performed at the International Identity Fest. Is that right?
Yeah, the Identity Fest. That's
okay,
right.
Okay, there you go. So will you be releasing that as a single anytime, or was that just like a Lucy or something?
Yeah, I what?
Like a Lucy. A Lucy, what? Like, it's not a single. It's just like...
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't know, man. Like, I want to release it, but, you know, I'm just trying to wait for, like, the right time to do it. Like, there's so much happening right now, like, internally for our group, so... we're really just, you know, back to, you know, the planning phase and really just making a lot of music And, you know, come January, we'll be releasing new stuff as well. So it's just kind of a lot happening. I'm just trying to find the best way and best time to release it. But yeah, I really like that track. I wrote it actually at the beginning of quarantine, just going through a bunch of stuff. And it was actually directed at myself.
Oh, cool. All right. And Brett, I remember you told me, you gave us like a little cliffhanger. You said that there's going to be a female artist and you can't tell who it is yet. And yeah. You said she's pretty known already. You can't even give us like a first letter of her name, bro. You can't give us nothing.
Sorry, like I can't say anything. You know,
come on, keep man.
Wraps, man. You know, you can't dish out these exclusives yet.
But it's me, though. Come on, bro. I got you.
Just to know.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
But when are you going to announce it? When will the official announcement be on that?
Hopefully by the beginning of next year.
Okay.
We plan to do the signing this year, but you know, we're still just waiting for the right time as usual.
All right. I got you. I'll stop asking about it now. There's this website. I don't think you guys have heard of it, or maybe you have. It's called collectivehustle.com. It's a website created to inspire Filipino youth. They're going to play the whole, yeah, they're going to play
like heard
whole,
about that.
The visual of Wildest Dreams for White Rabbit. And also for White Rabbit featuring Messiah. What do you enjoy most about the song or visual of White Rabbit? What do you guys like about it the most? I know you guys had your hands all over it, but anything that stands out to you where you would say that's your favorite part or favorite look?
In White Rabbit specifically?
Yeah.
I don't know. The whole thing is really just like a crazy ass dream. And like part of the reason why we wanted to release it all in one go, because when we plan to make, you know, six separate music videos, but by the time we had shot it and everything, it didn't make sense to release each one by one, because you need to watch it for the whole context. You right. know, if you watch it up until Glow and then end there, it just leaves you hanging. You need to, you know, have the full experience. So, yeah, it's hard to pick like a specific one that I like the most, because it's, you know, the bigger picture of the whole thing that really, you know, that I really love.
Okay. How about you, Brett? Any same answer?
Yeah. But, I mean, if I had to pick a scene, it's like, there's this one shot there, like this one shot where she looks like some kind of like Power Ranger, like, you know, flying forward and exploding.
Oh yeah.
That one?
That,
yeah.
That is great. Yeah. Just like Jamie said, it's about the overall message, and watching the whole thing really gives you that full message that we're trying to go for. So picking one scene is a little bit too hard.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I couldn't either. I was just wanting to see if you guys had one. But all right, what did you want to talk about for the fans right now? Like, I know you guys came on here to promote everything that's going on. Can you give us any information, anything that I didn't ask about yet about Careless, like what's to come? And
no, actually, right now, tonight on Kumu at what time would that be?
7 p.m.
At 7 p.m. on Kumu, we're having a live stream event where we are launching the Wildest Dreams merchandise.
Oh yes.
Sorry, that's at 6 p.m. Yeah, 6 p.m. on the Careless Kumu account, and yeah, we have different designs for each of the songs that are in the visual album.
This is the second drop, right?
This is the first drop.
We had the drop last night.
Oh, that's the one that came out. Last night, okay. It became available last night, but tonight there's a live event with all the fans and everyone on Kumu. So if you can make it, please check it out. And, you know, we'll all be there as well. And yeah, it's the merch was made by TriArt PH, and the designs were made by Hens, who's the creative director of Careless.
Dope.
Yeah. So we'll be coming out with more podcasts for the, you know, for the Wildest Dreams, with Nadine and Debbie Ten. And also we have a bunch of BTS coming out, you know, behind the scenes, and also director's commentary on, you know, the process of making the music, the process of making the music videos and everything, like a full backstage pass.
Wow. A lot going on, guys. That's great. I'm happy for Careless. And again, where can they find you on Kumu, though? Is it just Careless Music, or what is your account name?
It's Careless PH.
Careless PH. There you go. And yeah, I got some couple of random questions for you guys before I let you go. Because, you know, I had some fans asking me, especially Readers Official. They're crazy right now on Twitter and IG, DMing me. But they wanted to ask, what are your first thoughts about each other? What were your first thoughts about each other when you very first met you two?
Yeah, I tell the story to people, like, the first time I met Brett, it was back in the PBB house.
Right, right.
Yeah. And we were blindfolded, you know, standing, like, in the dark, blindfolded. And it was me and Brett standing next to each other. And I was just like, hey, what's up? And then he was like, hey. I was like, wow, you sound so American. He's like, you sound really Australian. So I'm just named Brett James. They're like, ah, okay, best friends, best friends. Like, we couldn't even see each other yet. But that we were like, we knew, like, okay, we're cool.
Yeah.
Just couldn't say the same thing for that guy on my other side, though.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say who he is.
Yeah, Brett shared that story, and you guys are like, nope, to the other guy, some random guy. He's trying to get in on the action, trying to be friends. Okay, if you guys could have any other expertise in any other field, what would you choose, both of you?
Like non-music related?
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh. Probably, you know, like my original passion when I was younger, when I was a teenager, was like, I always wanted to become a chef.
Oh, cool.
I was in Australia that I was studying to be a chef. And it was only when I moved here that I had to stop. But it's something I still love. I know I haven't got to, like, you know, go crazy on it. But if I wasn't doing music, I'd probably, you know, be a chef, be in hospitality.
Nice, nice. And you, Brett?
I think I just want to do more diving.
Diving?
That's
I've
what
never
could
been.
Be. Yeah, just like, I want it to be. I just want to see people diving. Let's go. Just anywhere.
Okay, cool. And a couple more.
Yeah, scuba instructor.
Scuba instructors, yeah. You know, I've never been scuba diving. I've only been snorkeling.
Yeah,
I've never even tried it. Are you really good at scuba? Are you, like, for real?
I'm also, like...
Yeah, I've been up to rescue diver. So that's one Ooh. Below master. And okay. Once you're a master, you can start teaching.
You might have to teach me once you get your master. That'll be dope, man. Okay, cool. All right, so who is the most responsible one in Careless? Be honest.
Actually, surprisingly, it's Brett.
Really? Okay. He's like, why is that a surprise, man?
No, just like on the outside, he wouldn't think so. Really? He's, you know, he's got okay. like the yeah. brain of a 16-year-old. But yeah, we call him Brett Tito.
All right. So I'm going to let you guys go. I know you're so busy. I want to thank you for your time. But one more time, the merch has dropped for Wildest Dreams. Each video has its own type of merch, right? Yep.
And the website for that, you can just go to shopnadinelustre.ph. That's the website.
That's it.
shopnadinelustre.ph.
Yeah, right. That's the one.
And I'm going to keep pressing. Guys, give me a hint, man. Who you guys are signing? Come on, give me a letter. Give me something. No?
You'll know. No. No, and you know.
No, you got to ask A&R.
You'll know when you know.
All right. Okay. Well, Brett, I'm going to keep bothering you about that. Maybe the next 3 days, I'm going to just keep texting and texting. And
I want to get more interviews out of you, man. That's why.
Oh. Okay, you're right. But, guys, thank you so much. And one last message for all your fans tuning in here in the Philippines and watching around the world. Can you guys give them a little
bit? Thank you so much for all of the support for Wildest Dreams. You know, we really appreciate it. And, you know, we're happy that it's something that, you know, really has gotten people thinking and, you know, like asking, you know, deeper questions about what it means to... you know, to break down mental barriers and what it means to grow. So we're really happy with the reception of it. And you know, please share it with your friends. Please share it with your family. You can stream it now on Spotify. It's on iTunes, Tidal, Deezer. And also all the songs are up on YouTube. So head over to the Careless channel, careless_ph. And hit subscribe. Yeah.
There you go. And sorry, one last thing. You've been appointed as the ambassador of the Department of Agriculture's Plant program, right? I didn't know that you were kind of into that and being an ambassador. And, you know, can you just give the people out there info for where they can find information on that. I won't ask like a long question. Is there any website or anything?
This year I became the ambassador for food security, and I've been working closely with the Department of Agriculture and Secretary Dar. But I think the latest initiative that we have is ReTerra. It's a design competition that it aims to, you know, it targets architecture students to help us come up with ways to, you know, solve the problems of food security and integrate agriculture into the city.
I see.
So you can go to the website, which is compete.design.
There you go.
It's simple, compete.design. And you can sign up with a group of friends and send in your designs, and we'd love to see them. Yeah.
Dope. Thank you so much once again, King Wah and James Reed. I wish you guys nothing but the best and success, and I'll probably talk to you guys soon. So God bless.
For sure. Thank you.
Peace out.
Peace, brother.